Good morning. I'm Janie Parrish with the Wadsworth Area Chamber of Commerce, and today we're zooming in right down the street to see Dr. Dane Ahrens at the Wadsworth Veterinary Hospital. So good morning, Dr. Ahrens.
Good morning, Janie. How are you?
Oh gosh, I'm so glad to see you. For the people that don't know, Dr. Ahrens was a board member with us for 6 years and he completed his terms last year. And we've been missing him. We've been missing the giggles. So it's good to see you this morning.
Good to see you too, honey.
Yeah, so I have some questions to ask you. Well, first of all, tell us about Wadsworth Veterinary Hospital.
Sure. Wadsworth Veterinary Hospital has been part of the Wadsworth community since 1954. We're in our 67th year of business here in Wadsworth, and we have not really grown in terms of the size of the facility, but we have definitely grown in terms of size of our client base, largely due to the fact that this is just a fantastic community to live and work in. When I first bought this place in 2004, we had about 598 clients, and we're up over almost 6,000 right now. So,
oh my gosh.
So we've definitely grown in terms of our service provider group. And definitely the number of patients that we have, that's over 10,000 patients that we see on an annual basis. But this has been a phenomenal place. And again, just an excellent community to grow and raise kids and have a family in. So I'm very, very proud to still be here after 67 years.
Now, what's unique about Wadsworth Veterinary Hospital?
Well, we're a private practice. So all animal clinic. We only see dogs and cats. We will occasionally see the pocket pet, so a rabbit or a guinea pig for a toenail trim or something pretty straightforward. Dr. Young and myself, my associate Dr. Brittany Young, neither of us are really that into the care and husbandry and veterinary management of pocket pets or the reptiles or any of the exotic species. And neither of us are interested in doing large animal stuff. So there's no equine or bovine medicine that we do here. So it's all cats and dogs pretty much. We definitely try to provide we call it low tech, high touch. We do have the some of the toys and some of the high speed, low drag tools that we use, a video otoscopy, so the clients can actually see what's going on down inside their dog or their cat's ears. We've got full scale anesthesia machine. We do lots of dental cleanings and other surgical procedures here, but we definitely rely on our high touch aspect where we're actually hands on talking to the clients about what's going on with their patient, what's going on with their pet, their fur baby, if you will, and making sure that they understand that we're on their side, that we are part of the care team, and it is very much a team effort between them and us and our staff.
Now tell me, why do you love what you do, Dr. Ahrens?
I wouldn't do anything else. I've done a lot of other stuff. I've been in the military. I did human medicine for a while. I was an EMT and I was on track to complete my undergrad in pre-med. So doing the human medicine side, I've worked in human hospitals. I've done research for a number of different medical device organizations. But when I found veterinary medicine, that's where I found my niche. That's what I fell in love with. That has been my passion for the last 27 years. And I wouldn't do anything else. It's just part of me. It's part of my life. It's part of what makes me me. It makes me want to get up and come to work every day.
Oh, and that's perfect. Yep. Hey, I wanted to ask you too, I've heard you have some great practices that you're using for safety during the pandemic. So say, for example, I bring my dog in, what would your safety procedures consist of?
So the first thing is still practicing curbside medicine. It's, we call it the drive-through veterinary clinic. The clients call us. There are a big sign on our door saying, please do not enter, you know, call us. And one of the staff members will come out and greet you and greet your pet. So the staff go out, they get a history by the car for our clients. And then we bring the animal in the building. The leashes, you know, cat carriers, those types of small animal carriers are taken away at that point, and they're disinfected while the doctor and the other staff members are looking at your pet. Everybody washes their hands. I probably literally wash my hands over 120, 130 times a day. We sanitize everything that goes back out with the client, including leashes. And as I said, the carriers, they're cleaned and then sent back out. And then the clients also are talked to right beside the curb. We'll go out and doctors will speak to the clients directly from their car. They don't even have to go to a nice warm car, and we'll discuss what's going on, make recommendations for treatments, make recommendations for medications, you know, surgical procedures, those types of things, after all of the vaccinations and other things are done while they're in the building. And we try and make it as easy and safe for our clients as possible. And this also for our staff.
Greatly appreciated. That's for sure. So tell us, how can people find you?
Well, we're on the web. Website is wadsworthvethospital.com. We also have a Facebook page. Our phone number is 330-335-4311. And that's all found on our website as well. We don't do a whole lot of social media. I'm a little bit of an older school kind of fuddy-duddy dude, but my staff are trying to poke me into having an Instagram page and having a Twitter account. And I'm not there yet, but someday maybe I'll jump into the 21st century and be a part of this digital revolution that is social media. But you can find us on our Facebook page, and it's just Wadsworth Veterinary Hospital. You can also find our hospital cat, Lieutenant Dan. He has his own Facebook page. In fact, he even has more friends than I do, I think. So.
Oh, you have to tell us about Lieutenant Dan before we go.
Well, Lieutenant Dan, yeah, he's our cranky little old kitty. Lieutenant Dan was found at about 4 months of age. A couple brought him in and said, hey, can you look at our cat? And when we brought Dan back, this is in the days before COVID, we could actually have clients in the building. We brought Dan to the back into the treatment area. The clients, the people, they weren't really clients. The people took off. So basically dumped him. On physical exam, he had the inability to walk. He was paralyzed essentially from his waist down. And we found a hole in his side. And so the suspicion was that he was shot with a pellet gun or a rifle or something. X-rays confirmed that he had a pellet lodged in his 11th thoracic vertebrae. And we took him to surgery and removed the pellet. And then a couple of months of physical rehab and some medications were unsuccessful at reversing the damage done to his spinal cord. So now he just lives here. And he's my hospital cat. And I thought Lieutenant Dan would be an appropriate name because I have a bit of a twisted sense of humor. And I love Forrest Gump. But his wheelchair is a little bit too small for him now. He's grown quite a bit since then and put on a few pounds, kind of like his veterinarian. And then that's about it, the story of Lieutenant Dan. He's our morale officer. He's our class clown.
Well, I don't think I've ever came into the clinic and to the hospital, your clinic, that he hasn't greeted me.
Yeah, he's our Walmart greeter for sure. Yeah. He's everybody who comes in the door.
Dr. Dane Ahrens of Wadsworth Veterinary Hospital, thank you so much. And thanks for all you do, not only to take care of our fur babies, but then also you're such a strong supporter of our community as well, including the Boy Scouts. You're my grandson's Boy Scout leader. So we appreciate that.
We miss those guys. Hard to get together. We were just talking. I had the committee meeting on Wednesday night, and we were talking about the Pinewood Derby that's coming up and the events that we'd like to have and virtual blue and gold ceremonies. And you know, we're trying to improvise, adapt, and overcome the best we can, but it's hard. You can't really tell a 8 and a 9 year old kid to stay away from their buddies when they're in a social setting like that. So
right. Yeah. But, now, how long have you been with the Scouts?
I've been the Cub Master for 5 years now. We were just talking about that too, as I'm getting ready to term out here in the not too distant future. But 5 years. I've got a son crossing over into the Boy Scouts from Cub Scouts, and then one more coming up through the ranks. But
Well, Dr. Aarons, thank you for everything, and you're always so fun to talk to.
Well, thank you, Janie.
Okay. But,
miss giving you guys hugs, and certainly we wish everybody safe journeys, travels, and health until all of this stuff cools down.
Okay, and we'll be out to see you then.
Sounds great. Okay. Thank you.
All right, thank you.